Hello students, in this lecture we will learn about the TS diagram of water, that is the temperature entropy diagram of water. Okay, so TS diagram of water is a thermodynamic property of water. It is depicting the thermodynamic properties of water and it is very useful for understanding the Rankine cycle, which is vapor power cycle. Okay, so right now I am just talking about how to understand the TS diagram of water and how to draw it. Okay, first of all, in case I ask you a question that what is boiling point of water, okay, your answer might be 100 degree centigrade, but this answer is wrong, because in case I ask you that what is boiling point of water, you must ask me that what is the pressure applied over it. It means what? That water doesn't have any fixed boiling point. The boiling point of water depends upon pressure applied over it. Okay, and what is boiling? We know this thing. Boiling is the phase change. Okay, when a liquid changes into vapor, then it is called as boiling. Okay, so in case I ask you that what is boiling point of water, then you must ask me that what is the pressure applied over it, because the boiling point of water depends upon the pressure applied over it. And not only water, all the liquids has such type of behavior, because every liquid has its boiling point. Boiling point is also called a saturation temperature. Okay, so every liquid has its saturation temperature. So for all the liquid, the rule is applicable, that is the boiling point depends upon the pressure applied over that liquid. For example, I have some data with me. This is the table for boiling point of water under different pressures. For example, this column stands for the pressure over water in bar, and this column stands for the corresponding boiling point. This is the data of water. For 1.01 bar, the boiling point is 100 degree centigrade. Okay. In case over same water, the pressure is 2 bars, then boiling point is 120.2 degree centigrade. And in case the pressure applied over it is 3 bars, then boiling point is 133.5 degree centigrade. And in case the same pressure is 5 bars, you can see boiling point is 151 degree centigrade. And in case the pressure is 0.06 bar, then the boiling point is 36.1 degree centigrade. Okay, this pressure 0.06 bar is even lower than 1.01 bar pressure. Actually, it is vacuum pressure. So what you see, that in case the pressure over water is increasing, the boiling point, the saturation temperature is also increasing. Okay, and in case pressure is lowering, for example 0.06 bar is even lower than 1.01 bar, then the boiling point is also less. Water will boil at 100 degree centigrade in case pressure over it is 1.01 bar, but in case pressure over it is 0.06 bar only, then it will boil at 36.1 degree centigrade, which is even lower than 100 degree centigrade. So you would have understood that there is no any fixed boiling point of water. It depends upon pressure applied over it. But since open atmosphere, in case you are boiling water in open atmosphere in an open container, then open atmosphere pressure is 1.01 bar, that is one atmospheric pressure. So everywhere the atmospheric pressure applied is always 1.01 bar. So almost over all places the water will boil at 100 degree centigrade in case you are boiling it in open container. I have some more data also, because I told you that this rule is applicable for all kinds of liquid. So for ammonia also, some data is there for ammonia, and all these data are collected from authentic sources. Okay, in case pressure applied over ammonia is 1.196 bar, then boiling point of ammonia is minus 30 degree centigrade. In case over same ammonia, the pressure is 6.14 bars, the boiling point is 10 degree centigrade. In case over same ammonia, the pressure is 20.33 bar, then boiling point is 50 degree centigrade. So you can see ammonia is also behaving the same, that in case you are increasing the pressure over the ammonia, the boiling point is increasing, and in case pressure is decreasing, then boiling point is also decreasing. Okay. Now, suppose this is the piston cylinder system in which some water is present. This blue color entity is the water. And now we will try to understand how to draw the TS diagram of water. Okay. TS diagram means temperature and entropy diagram. Okay. We know this thing, that the entropy change is given by dS equals to del Q by T. Here T is the absolute temperature, that is the temperature in Kelvin, and del Q is the amount of heat added or removed. Okay. Remember, in case we add any heat to the system, the entropy increases, and in case we remove any heat from the system, the entropy decreases. Okay. So in case del Q is positive, that is we are adding the heat, then the entropy change will be positive. And in case del Q is negative, that is heat is departing from any system, then entropy change is negative. So entropy change is given by del Q by T. So this entropy, x axis stands for entropy and y axis stands for the temperature. Okay. Now at 0 degree centigrade, okay, the entropy of water is taken as 0. Remember this thing. This datum is chosen only for water. Remember, at 0 degree centigrade, the temperature is 273 Kelvin. Okay, so for 0 degree centigrade, you can find in all steam tables that at 0 degree centigrade, the entropy of water is considered as 0. It is just chosen as datum that at 0 degree centigrade, the entropy of water is taken as 0, especially when we are talking in regards of thermodynamic properties of steam. Okay, this is the piston cylinder system in which some water is present, and this is the piston. Okay, the pressure applied over the piston is 1 bar, suppose. It means the pressure applied over the water is also 1 bar, and we are supplying heat to it. And suppose the initial temperature of water is 0 degree centigrade. Okay, when we have started the experiment, then the liquid water's temperature is 0 degree centigrade. Okay, now heat is added. So what you see, that since addition of heat will correspond to what? The increment in entropy. So you can see the pressure is 1 bar, and I told you that for 1 bar pressure, the boiling point is approximately 100 degree centigrade. However, it is for 1.01 bar pressure, but for 1 bar pressure also, you can take more or less the boiling point of water to be 100 degree centigrade. So over here, in case pressure over it is 1 bar, and initially the water's temperature is 0 degree centigrade. Now in case you are adding heat, what will happen? Since addition of heat will increase the entropy, and since heat is added to this liquid water, the temperature will also rise. So both things are taking place. So you can see this line. Okay, so from 0 degree centigrade, the temperature of water is rising. Ultimately, it reaches to its saturation temperature, that is 100 degree centigrade, because for 1 bar pressure, the boiling point is 100 degree centigrade. Okay, now you can see that this line has gone straight, horizontal line. Can you tell why? The reason is that however we are adding heat to this water, but actually at 100 degree centigrade, the boiling point has come. So now phase change will occur, and when phase change occurs, then actually the liquid needs what? The latent heat of vaporization. So over here, between these two points, actually water is absorbing the latent heat, and when latent heat is added, the temperature remains constant. Remember that whenever phase change occurs of any liquid, from liquid to vapor, the temperature remains constant. This is the reason that when boiling point has been reached, then with addition of heat, entropy will increase, but temperature will not, because actually heat addition is taking place. Due to that thing, entropy is increasing, but that is latent heat addition, and latent heat addition always happens at constant temperature. Okay. Ultimately, this water completely converts into vapor. Initially, it was in liquid form, and ultimately, it has been converted into vapor. Okay. When the entire water converts into vapor, if we are still adding heat, now what will happen? The vapor's temperature will start rising. You can see that 100 degree centigrade, now the temperature again starts rising. Okay, so once the phase has been changed, then still if we are adding heat, then since due to addition of heat, entropy always increases, and since the vapor formation has took place, means for entire water the phase has been changed, now whatever heat we will add, it will lead to increment in temperature of vapor. Okay, so what will happen? With further addition of heat, the entropy and temperature both will start rising again. Okay, now in case over same piston cylinder system, the pressure becomes 2 bar. Okay, then for 2 bar pressure, suppose initial temperature is 0 degree centigrade, then again the same process will happen. From 0 degree centigrade, it will reach to its boiling point, because at 2 bar pressure, the boiling point is how much? Approximately 120 degree centigrade. Okay, so what will happen? In case the pressure applied over the water is 2 bar, then from 0 degree centigrade, it will reach to its boiling point. Okay, so up to that much point, what will happen? Entropy and temperature both will increase. At 120 degree centigrade, there will be change of phase. Ultimately, the entire water will convert into vapor. With further addition of heat, entropy and temperature will start rising both, because once the vapor has been formed, then the temperature of vapor will start rising, as well as heat addition is continuously taking place. So entropy is also increasing of vapor, as well as temperature of vapor is also rising. In case the pressure becomes 5 bar, then it is like this. From 0 degree centigrade, it is reaching to its boiling point, that is 151 degree centigrade, then change of phase, and then temperature rise of vapor. Okay, like this. Okay, so what you see over here, that with rising of pressure, 1 bar, 2 bar and 5 bar, you can see continuously the boiling point is rising. But you can see one thing more, that the amount of latent heat required for change of phase is decreasing. You can see the length, you can observe the length of this line. This length, as I am showing by the arrow, this length corresponds to the latent heat addition for 1 bar pressure. This length corresponds to latent heat addition for 2 bar pressure. This length corresponds to latent heat addition for 5 bar pressure. This length is reducing. So in case this TS diagram is scaled, then you can easily observe that with rise of pressure, the boiling point is rising, but the amount of latent heat required for change of phase is continuously decreasing. So in case the tendency is so, there must be some pressure at which the latent heat addition for change of phase could be zero because it is continuously decreasing with rise of pressure. So there must be some pressure at which the latent heat required for change of phase is zero. Yes, of course, for the case of water, it is 225 bar pressure. It is called as critical pressure of water. Critical pressure is that pressure beyond which no amount of latent heat is required for change of phase. You can see over here, the latent heat becomes zero. So in case I am connecting all these either points of all these curves, then ultimately I will get a dome or not like this. I am connecting all these points, ultimately reaching to this critical pressure like this. This type of dome I will get, and you can easily see that in case I take any one line, then up to reaching the boiling point, the phase of water is liquid, because until and unless the boiling point has been reached, the water remains in liquid form. And when there is phase change occurring, you can see this line corresponds to the change of phase of liquid water. Okay, so in this line, what is the phase of water? It is binary phase, neither fully liquid nor fully vapor. So inside this dome, the water will be in form of liquid plus vapor. And to the right hand side of this dome, you can see as it has been fully converted into vapor. Okay, then to the right hand side, it is fully vapor. Okay, so this is what the TS diagram of water. That's it. Okay, which tells that there is a dome. Inside the dome, the phase of water is liquid plus vapor. Why it is so? Once again, I am telling that you can see this line is starting from, suppose I am choosing this 2 bar line. So from 0 degree centigrade up to the boiling point, it is in liquid form. Okay. As well as for 5 bar also, 0 degree centigrade up to the 151 degree centigrade. Again, water is in liquid form. For 1 bar pressure, 0 degree centigrade to 100 degree centigrade, it is in liquid form. Okay. So you can say that in case I am choosing this line, this curve of this dome, then toward the left hand side, always the water is in liquid form. When the boiling point has been reached, now this straight line corresponds to what? Corresponds to the change of phase of water. Okay. So all these lines, because inside this dome, it corresponds to many horizontal lines. All those lines corresponds to what? Liquid plus vapor. So inside this dome, the phase of water is liquid plus vapor. And to the right hand side, in case I am taking this line of dome, this right half of this dome. So at this point, any point in case I choose, the water has been converted fully into vapor. So beyond this point, water is what? Fully vapor. Okay, in vapor form. Okay, so to the right hand side of this dome, you can say that it is composed of all those lines which are in vapor form. These are also called as superheated vapor lines. Okay, so to the right hand side of this dome, the phase of water is vapor form. Okay, this. Now we will talk about some terminologies in connection with the TS diagram of water. Okay, suppose I am taking the case of 2 bar pressure is applied over it, then the line goes like this, starting from 0 degree centigrade reaching the boiling point, that is 120 degree centigrade, then change of phase, and then increment of temperature of vapor like this, as well as the entropy increase. Okay, in case I straighten this line, then it will look like this. This is arrow diagram. Okay, you can see these are the points where the line is changing its slope. So in case I straighten this entire line, it will look like this. Okay, now let's talk. Starting from 0 degree centigrade up to the boiling point, the water is called as subcooled liquid. Okay, until and unless the boiling point has been reached, it is in liquid state, so it is called as subcooled liquid. Okay, just at the boiling point, when boiling point has just arrived, at that point it is called as saturated liquid. Remember, for example, for 2 bar pressure, the boiling point is how much? 120 degree centigrade. So exactly at 120 degree centigrade, the water will be termed as saturated liquid. Okay, now beyond this point, what is happening? Latent heat is added, so ultimately it will convert into steam at the same temperature, because when the latent heat is added, then temperature doesn't changes. Okay, so between those two points, the water is neither fully in vapor form and nor fully in liquid form, so it is called as wet steam. Okay, at this point the water has converted into vapor, at this point it is saturated liquid. So between these two points, water is called as wet steam. It is in binary phase, liquid as plus vapor. Okay, exactly at the point when entire water converts into vapor, exactly at that point, it is termed as saturated vapor. Okay, means this point. Okay, so at this point, water will be termed as saturated vapor. And beyond this point, still heat addition is taking place. It is called as superheated vapor. So you can see that water can exist in 5 different forms. That is subcooled liquid, that is below the boiling point of water, and the saturated liquid exactly at boiling point of water, and wet steam means the phase conversion is taking place. Water is in liquid plus vapor form. Then when it has just been converted into vapor, it is called as saturated vapor. And beyond that point, if still we are adding heat, then it is called as superheated vapor. You can see the temperature of vapor is rising like this. Okay, So generally TS diagram is shown like this, that is TS you can show, and only dome is made. Inside this dome, the face of water is liquid plus vapor, to the right hand side it is vapor, and to the left hand side it is liquid. So hope you would have understood that why it is so and why the TS diagram is made like so. Thank you.